independent agencies differentiating themselves in today's current environment?
The changes in the landscape over the past 15 years have been dramatic. If you think back, it was individual doctors in the fee-for-service world making decisions of products that they use. Now that the landscape has changed and dominant healthcare systems own 60% of the doctors in the United States, it's really a B2B sell. Historically, you'd need a salesman to call on independent doctors. Now, a key account manager can call on a major system and change behavior in 1,000 doctors quickly. That B2B model is the essence of what we do. We do that by looking at the drivers of healthcare delivery and making certain that our clients position the products with our assistants in the workflow design that meet the key issues that they're facing. In fee-for-service, it was basically you did something and were paid for it. In 2018, it's the quadruple aim. Oh, it's still clinical outcomes. That still remains a fundamental, but it's balanced by cost and efficiency. Many choices of products. Which one is the best cost-effective choice that reaches the outcome? Patient satisfaction is gathering in importance. And finally, there's an opportunity to work with practices to make it simple. It's no longer the doctor as the lead in giving care to a patient. It's a team in that practice. And how you work with that team is what differentiates your product from other products.
What's different about the way you do business with your clients?
So there's three areas that were different. The first is knowledge. We built a consultancy that redesigned care delivery for many large health systems. That consultancy gives us remarkable insight into the way care is delivered at a very granular level. Our teams actually work with case managers and listen to how they talk to patients and script them, script doctors for referrals, design models that improve care delivery. That knowledge enables us to build programs for our clients that provide solutions for their clients, not products. They become not vendors, but partners. The second area is new business. We work with ACOs around the country, and one of them, a decade-long relationship, was targeted by our client, who had no relationship there. We took them down there, had a meeting with 15 people, including representatives of the major health systems that own them, and discussed new value-based contracting models that they were extremely interested in. The result? A program is being developed to put those value-based contracts in place and potentially expand at these very large systems. And finally, our deliverables. We don't work usually on an hourly basis. We have project fees. And those project fees are defined because of our expertise. We understand how to build these models. We can build them with efficiency. And we actually go and assist in the implementation without waste or duplication.
The healthcare landscape is very complex, as we know. And one of the big challenges for pharma is payer access. What role is payer access playing in launch strategies now?
We've launched over 50 products into the health system market segment. We understand what drives them very well. Today's environment is quite a bit different than it was even 10 years ago. There's one overriding issue that the industry has to understand. The joint contracting between payer and provider has created a complete focus on risk. Health systems don't make a lot of money. And managing the risk, downside risk in particular, is a substantial issue for them to address. He who holds the risk makes the rules. Kinetix spends several hundred thousand dollars a year developing innovative programs to enable us to maintain the lead in understanding our customer's customer.